Lumandwa the fashion designer. So we talk about the label at Lumandwa. So the second thing to do would be to establish your communication platforms. So while we all know that you're supposed to be on Twitter, Facebook, have a website, have a web presence, a lot of people are not necessarily utilizing these platforms to get themselves heard. So the first and obvious platform for a lot of people would be the website, right? What are you putting on your website for the media? The website, I usually say, is the most important tool. So when you're talking about the website, we're talking about who you are, where you've studied, what your awards are like, what different collections you have, and what current collection you have, right? So the website also allows you to have links to your social media sites where people find different information about. So there'll obviously be the links to the Facebook, Twitter, your blog, Pinterest account, and your video platforms. Great. So now you've set up those different platforms. The other thing to think about is when the media go to those sites, what are they looking for, right? So remember that your website is your commercial tool. You want buyers to go over there, you want fans, people who want to buy your clothes to go on there, but you also want the media to know what you've been up to. So all the press clippings, all the videos, any press mentions that you've ever got need to be consolidated in your website. Let's talk about Facebook and what you can do with Facebook. So again, remember that social media platforms are not as, if I go to your Facebook page, I don't care where you partied last week, not as a media person. I want to see your clothes, I want to know what colors, what trend, what is your thought process. For me, what's important about your Facebook page would be what you're telling the other people around you. And that's what it makes me realize whether you're creating a buzz about your brand or not. Are people talking about you? What stories are you putting out there? So use your Facebook page to promote your collections, promote deals, and your events. Sell using your Facebook page, the different Facebook templates that now allow people to sell their clothes on Facebook. If you don't understand how to do this, look at what Sokoku is doing. Sokoku is the biggest e-commerce site today on Facebook, right? Sokoku. Anyone is selling with Sokoku, right? If your boyfriend gave you a diamond ring and you're trying to get rid of it, sell it on Sokoku. You can do anything on that site, right? So designers should be able to sell their clothes, all seasons clothes. Do whatever you have, do on those sites, right? This is also your opportunity to show your style prowess. So become an authority on looks, engage your audience. If someone wore your clothes, say I'm wearing a jacket by Chip Crossword, put it on Facebook. Borrow from people who are already promoting you, even if subconsciously, right? So that's what you do with Facebook. Now, we all know Anne McCreath, right? The reason Anne is here is because she's one of the few designers who are out there. When you want the media to pick you up, and this is just an example, there are other designers. When you want the media to pick you up, you have to be visible. And I just wrote a few pointers, so we're not just necessarily talking about one person, but what can everybody do to become visible or able to the media. So the first thing is to manage your relationships. Attend events such as this one, expos, trade shows, make yourself accessible to buyers, consumers, and the media. When it comes to your events, create your own events. There are pop-up shops, there's so many fashion events you can do. And if they cost money, partner with different designers. They don't necessarily have to be competitive. Competition, partner with accessory designers, just different people who will help cover the cost of putting up that event. Your visibility. Media will never interview people who are not accessible to them. If I call someone and they didn't pick up and didn't return my call, why would I bother, right? There's so many designers in the country, there's so many designers across the continent. So again, access is very important. Dress significant people who talk at speaking engagements, people who like your clothes, they don't necessarily have to have known you. If you support your clothes somewhere, it also have wonderful design at Tukulu. The different designers in here, if you see someone wearing your clothes, put that picture on Facebook. Make people aware that your brand is out there. So, here's a little case study. In 2009, Gloria Omuno attended the Africa Fashion International. Gloria Omuno is a Ugandan designer. Right after that, Arise magazine put out a fashion editorial. And Oluchi modeled for that fashion editorial. That was the first time Oluchi was modeling for Arise, which meant that they picked up her picture, and by coincidence, Gloria Omuno was wearing that dress. Gloria was only 24. Today she's attended 6 major fashion events on invite. Her career has spiraled, right? So again, being out there, taking a risk, paying the extra shilling to attend a fashion event, you're never too small to go global. The media will pick you up, and that's what happens, right? So these are just little tips: get noticed by the media, look for brand ambassadors for your clothes or brands, get the right person to wear your clothes. Do not give your friends free clothes. They're not your brand ambassadors. They have no brand equity for you to borrow from, right? If you're going to spend 3 days, 4 days, 1 week making an outfit, give it to a fashion icon, give it to someone who will speak at an engagement, give it to a media personality. Do not dress your friends for free, right? Attend major fashion international weeks that make sense. I'm not saying the small ones are not good enough, but then again, you're just competing in your own field, yeah? Go far, go out of the country, experiment in different markets, find out what people want. You may just make your break there. Think global, whether it's brand ambassadors. By the way, I don't think my Angelina Jolie's not wearing your clothes much. Oh, see? Think of global brand ambassadors. That's what happened to Lanesso. She was born, Kate Boss wore a Lanesso hat, and before you knew it, they were sold out at Topshop. Retail globally, even if online, there's so many online sites looking for different designers. Samantha mentioned that she worked on a project. Follow people like that, but have good quality products. And then, something that I find a lot of designers forget to do, your space that you work in is now beautiful. So it's not aesthetic enough for us to film you at. So, print maps differently where a beautiful picture can sell a lot. If you have 2-3 minutes of video, let that space look beautiful. Okay, that's Alicia Keys, and she's wearing a Christy Brown necklace. Christy Brown is a Ghanaian designer. So manage your relationships, know who will make things make sense for you. I mean, in terms of publicity, talk to stylists, build a media list. Your contact should span media people in business, arts, events, and fashion reporters, right? So, fashion is not just about looking good and making people look good. There's a business of fashion. There are so many ways, different sectors in any publication, having a works here for different media, both lifestyle and business. In fact, you should say something after this. But, so you will know that your best media might not come from fashion people. Especially not in the beginning, right? And also find out what to say to who. If I was a business reporter and you're talking to me about how somebody dressed up last week, I'll dismiss you within the past 2 minutes. Think about what to tell different people. How is the secondhand market affecting your industry? How are different laws and regulations affecting business practice in fashion? How can you combine art and business or fashion? So those are the things to just think about when you engage different media personalities. Start local, going international, or vice versa, depending on your brand strategy. If you'd like to sell the international market, that's the market you're supposed to be focusing on, the local media will pick you up anyway, because if you're doing what we said at the beginning, you put up that press alert, and people will know that you're being profiled. Be social and friendly. Remember, the media are not as stylish as designers, right? So if I'm calling you to talk to you and you're looking at me up and down and wondering what I'm wearing, and arm your access to fame or business, remember to always be social and friendly to all media. Network outside the industry, go for business networks, join the Rotary, network. It does not have to be in the industry. In fact, you have less chances of making it in the industry than networking outside. Do your research and find out what information people are looking for. People could be talking about, people might want to find an opinion. Do you guys know what an opinion is in the press?
Yeah.
So that's basically when someone's doing a paper on something, or an article or a feature, and they call Mark of Sandstone to say, hey, how are you affected by the leather